Hiya! Welcome
to the first records roundup of 2023. And rather nicely, I've got quite a mixture of formats to show you on this first edition in the new year. And we're going to start with a mail opening, although it's come and it's got a big tear in it, so I'm lucky that the mail didn't open itself in transit. Even so, let's tear this open. This is an order from Mute Bank, Mute Records web store. There we've got an invoice. Oh yeah, we've got a little bit of a freebie there. I'll get onto that in a sec. I thought there might be a little free gift from when I got an email from Mute Bank shortly before I ordered these. You know, one of my favourite bands that are on Mute Records. I've been threatening to fill some holes in the collection with CDs, one CD in particular that I think I'll show you first. And I'm talking about Lieback. And this is their, I think it might be their seventh studio album. The information will be on screen in a moment anyway, to correct me if I'm wrong. Volk. So yeah, I finally decided to get the CD, as this hasn't come out on vinyl yet. I was trying to exclusively collect Lieback on vinyl, and I've also got a DVD and a Blu-ray. I had an email from Mute Bank saying, oh well, we're still clearing out some of our warehouses, so we've reduced a load of stock. They did that sort of around Black Friday, and I missed out on the one remaining Erasure album that I needed. It goes for like almost £200 on eBay and Discogs, and Mute had probably one in their warehouse and they were selling it for like 40 quid. And I wasn't quick enough. Someone quite rightly snapped that up really quick. But Mute had another sort of end of year clearance. This and the next CD were still very cheap. This one was either £4 or £5, and the other one obviously made it a total of £9, and then a few extra quid in postage. Volk, not to be confused with Wir sind das Volk, which is Lieback's most recent album that came out in 2022. This is sort of their avant-garde industrial interpretations on sort of national anthems and things, really. So really happy I finally got this. If it ever comes out on vinyl, I will no doubt get it, and then I may send this CD out to someone as some VCLT if they want it. For now, and for however long, it may never come out on vinyl, which is fair enough. I've got Volk, and the other one I decided to get, a little bit less necessary, although I think there'll still be a couple of tracks on here that I'm not familiar with, is this Introduction to Lieback CD. This one is sort of like a greatest hits, you can't really say that about Lieback, but a kind of compilation, but it compiles all their best known and best loved cover versions. Anyone who knows even a little bit about Lieback is that they're probably more famous for the cover versions than for whatever they've written themselves, really. So we've got Warme Lederhaut, which is their cover of Warm Leatherette. There's a couple of tracks off the Volk album that I've just shown you. It'll have a couple of things off their Let It Be covers album, yeah, Across the Universe and Get Back. Final Countdown, cover of Europe. Opus Dei, which is their cover of Life is Life. Just thought I'd get this, seeing as how this was going really cheap at Mute's sale as well. So an Introduction to Lieback, and also Lieback's Volk, both from Mute Bank. Oh, and if there's any sudden cuts during this video, by the way, that'll be because I've had to cut out copyright blocked music after the fact.
Scatter your enemies, confound their politics, so you still believe you're ruling the world.
Oh, I almost forgot to show you this free gift from Mute. I think it's meant to be like a sort of promo CD, really. It says Number One Against the Rush by Liars. I've heard of Liars. I don't know if I've heard any of their music, but I think it's because I see them prominently advertised on Mute Bank, and I think this is meant to be like a promo CD. I did remember when Mute sent their email about the clearance sale out, they did say every order will throw in like a free promo CD, so this will be mine. Don't think there's going to be much to say about it, really. I think there's only two tracks on it as well, so it's kind of like a promo single. I will listen to that, I'll see what it's like. And it's quite a nice minimal, but with the proper Mute logos and everything on. It's not some sort of handwritten thing. It's fairly good quality for a rather minimal sleeve. But that is a Liar's promo single, presumably. Right then, can move on now to the first MiniDisc pickup that I've made in quite some time. And this is a proper old school original MiniDisc as well. I don't look for MiniDiscs as often as I used to, mainly because, well, two reasons. A, I collect more vinyl now, as you know, and B, all the MiniDiscs that I really wanted, all the albums on MD that I was really wanting to own, I pretty much got the vast majority of them a long time ago, so anything that I've picked up in more recent years has tended to be, not always, but tended to be a bit impulsive just because I've got it for cheap. And I suppose I could say the same about Liquid Skin by Gomez. So this is Gomez's second studio album. It was the follow-up to their Mercury award-winning Bring It On, which I also have on MiniDisc. That was a quite a cheap pickup some years ago. And I got this because it was cheap. I mean, £19, which you might argue, well, that's not cheap, because the CD probably costs like a quid or something. But for a MiniDisc, an original MD, trust me, that is a good price, and that was with free postage on eBay as well. A bit of a look at the MiniDisc itself there. Gomez, I know the first album, Bring It On, and I've not listened to it in years. I've only listened to it once since I bought it. It received a lot of hype, as a lot of Mercury-nominated artists do. It was all right. It's the sort of thing, if I probably listened to it again, it would grow on me and continue to grow. But I liked it enough that I would certainly take a punt on Liquid Skin. Whether this will be a better album, it could well be. I might prefer it. Gomez, for those who don't know him, I think they're still going. Don't quote me on that, though. They're sort of like an indie blues band, really, is the best way to describe them. Sort of a little bit unusual sound, but definitely got a blues influence in there. And I thought £19. Nice condition, MD as well. It doesn't really bother me, but a lot of the times when you buy original MiniDisc albums on the aftermarket, then you've got cracked cases, in fact loads of them, that I just ignore. Like, I'm missing the cases and the booklets completely. You know, if I'm buying a MiniDisc, I want one that's got its full artwork and everything, even if I don't mind the case being quite roughly damaged, because you can replace these cases quite easily now. There we are, Liquid Skin by Gomez. On to a single that I purchased on Discogs, and when I pre-ordered and then it came out a few weeks back, the People Like Us and Ergo Fizmiz Rhapsody in Glue album on Bandcamp, it got me to thinking, do I need to fill any of my People Like Us holes? They've released so much stuff. They, it's one woman, Vicky Bennett, but she does collaborate with a lot of people like Matt Moss, Ergo Fizmiz, etc. I looked at Vicky's Discogs database, all the releases that have been catalogued there. There's still sort of like a lot of the CDs that really were only out in very limited quantities. I don't think I'll ever be able to get those unless I get really lucky. And then I looked at the singles, and there was a very cheap single there, and I thought, well, I don't know why I haven't picked that up before now, just because it's so cheap, and even if I've got both the tracks on an album, then I might as well buy it anyway just for the collection. And it's this single here. It's limited copies, I think, When I Was Young and Downtown Once More, so probably classed as a double A-side. It doesn't really get more of a plainer sleeve than that, does it? Just a white 7-inch record sleeve with a fairly inconspicuous label on it. I know Downtown Once More is on an album, it's on A Bridge Too Far, but I couldn't find When I Was Young on any of the albums in my collection, so perhaps I don't actually own that already. Even if I did, it wouldn't matter. I just thought it'd be good to get a cheap People Like Us single, and I'd seen this ages ago, and for some reason I've not bought it. I've just realised the hype or the info sticker's actually stuck to the outer sleeve. I don't think this is coloured vinyl, as far as I know. I'm just getting it out because it's easy to. No, it looks like a black 7-inch, this. Yeah. Very sort of plainly done. This wasn't much, I think, including postage. It wasn't much more than about £4, £4.50, I think. And I love People Like Us. I've talked about Vicky and her music. You can't even call it music a lot of the time before. I did a video which showed a lot of purchases of People Like Us records and CDs quite some time ago. It's called People Like Jimmy Barnes Like People Like Us. That's a good place to start, really, if you just want to learn about Vicky Bennett, aka People Like Us, in my music collecting playlist. It's quite an old video, that, now. I might be getting on for 2 years old, so you need to scroll down some to find it. But there we are. Really glad I've got that. There is one or two other singles, I think, from People Like Us that are a little bit more expensive, and they're also being sold internationally, so I need to decide whether I want to pay customs and extra postage just to say I've got more of the singles. But not many singles out by her. This one was certainly a cheapo, and I'm glad I've got it. Now we can move on to some vinyl albums. There's two here from the same artist. I think these were purchases from a Discogs seller, if memory serves. Mentioned in the last Records Roundup video and previous to that as well. As this band only released 4 studio albums, I'm going to get this collection done and dusted pretty quickly. And I have done, so it's a complete studio albums collection that I've made today, certainly. And we'll start with what I think is considered The Smiths' most popular and well-received album. All their stuff was well-received, really, but particularly this one, I think people have got a special fondness for. Their third album, The Queen Is Dead. I like that this one has got a nice hype on it. I do believe this is also a gatefold sleeve as well. I'm not going to get it open. It's just black vinyl to show you. My all-time favourite Smith song, There Is a Light That Never Goes Out, is on here. Really should have been a single originally. It wasn't. It did eventually come out as a single in the early 90s to promote a hits compilation. That should have been a single right from the get going. When was this released? 86, this would have been. Also, big singles on here are Big Mouth Strikes Again, The Boy with the Thorn in His Side, and this other album tracks I'm familiar with, such as Cemetery Gates, Some Girls Are Bigger Than Others, I Know It's Over. So, yeah, I'll have heard almost all, if not all, of The Queen Is Dead, certainly. Can't remember the price I paid for this and the next one. They were both reasonable from the one seller on Discogs, and I like the fact that they were still new and sealed as well. I've been getting these Smiths remasters. And so, as I've completed the collection, here's the fourth and final Smiths studio album, Strange Ways Here We Come. I think this came out just after they split up. Any more expert Smiths fan can correct me if I'm wrong there, please do. Oh god, that's some small text on the back there that I'm going to struggle with without my glasses. What singles and stuff on here am I familiar with? Girlfriend in a Coma, I've seen that. Brilliant track, absolutely marvellous. Stop me if you think you've heard this one before, is also on here. The Smiths collection complete, and I am glad. I say complete. There's still other compilation albums similar to Louder Than Bombs, which I've owned for a couple of years now. I'll probably try and pick those up because they'll have other singles and maybe radio sessions and things like that, because the Smiths in the 80s, they were quite gung-ho, or at least their American record label was quite gung-ho about releasing compilations. Sire Records, I think, were their American distributor. At least two or three Smiths compilations came out during the 1980s just to compile all the singles and things that weren't on the actual studio albums. So yeah, I may pick up a couple of those at some point if I find them at a good price, but the main thing was to get all the studio albums, and I've completed it with Strange Ways Here We Come.
Driving in your car. It's not my home, it's their home, and I'm welcome no more. And if a double-decker bus crashes into us, to die by your side is such a heavenly way to die. And if a ten-ton truck
And finally, I thought this was going to be quite an epic one, and I've shown you a lot of stuff, but see if you're getting through this fairly quickly. But this is one that's part of my New Order and related doubling up project, for want of a better term. And also, nicely, this relates to the Smiths, because it's Johnny Marr from the Smiths and Bernard Sumner from New Order. This is the 2020 reissue of the amazing, one of my all-time favourite albums, this self-titled electronic studio album from the super duo of Manchester themselves. I've fancied having this on vinyl. I've had the re-released CD that's got a bonus disc of mixes and B-sides and things, but I've fancied the vinyl version of this for ages now. I've just held off because I wanted the white vinyl edition, and that just seems really rare. Like, I missed the boat on that when it first came out, and then no one seems to be selling that unless it's for a really ridiculous price on the aftermarket. This isn't the white vinyl edition, this will just be the standard black, but I decided I would get this on eBay because the seller had taken about 35% off it. Brand new, as you can see, it is still sealed. The price with free postage on eBay was a little bit over £20, and I thought, well, just for the sake of waiting around for a colour variant that I may never get, or if I do get, I'm going to be paying through the nose for, I just want the album on record more than anything. £20 is a good price for this on the standard black vinyl format. So why not? I'm really glad that I finally picked it up, albeit on black rather than white disc. I love this album so much. It's up there with my very favourite New Order work, really. I mean, electronic, for me, they were just the ultimate spin-off for many years, really. Just quality. And I love the fact that there's a few collaborations with Pet Shop Boys on here. Three really strong singles, Getting Away With It, Get the Message, Feel Every Beat. But it's some of the album tracks on here that I love the most. Tighten Up is fantastic. Gangster is amazing. Try All You Want. It's all quality, really. I don't know why I'm singling certain tracks out, because it's just a thoroughly excellent album from start to finish. So if you do see this on vinyl or whatever format you prefer to collect music on, going at a good price, just pick it up and just give it a go. That's a recommendation. Whether Garage Geek, who does listen to stuff that's recommended to him, whether he'll take me up on this particular recommendation, I don't know. But you should do, David, and so should everyone else. In fact, the brilliant from, this would have been 1991, electronic self-titled debut.
Have you ever been a victim in a violent fight when you know it's not true and you know it's not right? You got not 1 ounce of inch control. You got lust for blood running in your soul. You know if every person upon this earth became the image of the mother in a violent birth, we could sow the seed, stop the sand, and heal this brutal feet of man. Yeah.
And there we are, that's Records Roundup 18, done and dusted, the first one of 2023. I want to thank you all for watching, and I also want to thank everyone who has entered the JB2K contest so far here in the vinyl community on YouTube. There is probably a little over 4 weeks left to run in the contest now, because it doesn't end till February the 2nd, so still the best part of a month for you to get involved. Those of you who've said you're getting involved and you haven't yet, I mean, you've still got plenty of time. Just let me know in the original comment section for the original video, which of course is linked at the very top of the description, when you have made a video entry. It's very simple. First prize £50, second prize £25. Why wouldn't you enter? It's money in your pocket. It'd be nice if you spent it on records or music, but it's entirely up to you. I don't judge. I'll just send the winner their prize and the runner-up their prize as well via PayPal probably, and you can do with it as you wish. Also, down in my description text box is a referral link for HMV and also my Patreon group and Facebook group as well. And of course, I want to say a massive thank you, as always do, to all of my subscribers, and we're quite close to the 2,000 mark, but for me, the contest wasn't solely about getting a push to 2,000. I just thought it was a good time to run a contest, as I was as close to 2,000 as I'd ever been. You know, if I get there by February the 2nd, brilliant. If I don't, doesn't matter. And of course, I want to say before I go, a massive thank you to all my patrons as well. So I am going to go now. Got loads to listen to on different formats as well. Got a mini disc from Gomez, a couple of Lieback CDs, including the intriguing Valk album that I've been itching to hear for the best part of a year now. And of course, some great stuff reissued by Electronic and the Smiths. And I do hope that all of you will join me again next time for my next records roundup and music collecting video. Cheers, everyone. See ya!